बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलामुअलैकुम। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी वर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कॉन्सेप्ट्स फॉर द फोरकास्टिंग अप्रोच। वन ऑफ द इम्पॉर्टेंट अप्रोच दैट विल वाइडली यूज फॉर द डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम। मोर ओवर इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द वेरियस टाइप ऑफ द टेक्निक्स दैट विल बी यूज इन द स्टेशनरी मॉडल। Stationary, what is stationary model? Stationary time series. It is a one whose statistical properties, that is the mean of variances, autocorrelation, they are constant. They are not changing over the interval of time. Moreover, we also discuss about the last period method, then the moving average method, and the weighted moving average method. This is what we have discussed in the previous. Now, starting with the today, Galaxy Industries is interested in forecasting weekly demand for its YOHO brand yo-yos. Similar, for example, Samsung company, they are interested about their Samsung 9, Samsung 10, Samsung 11, etc. They are different brands, they have the different brand version were there, and they have the data for 52 for 1 year. 1 year means they have the demand for the weekly demand for the whole year, weekly demand. Then the yo-yo is a mature product. As we saw, if the mature product yo-yo is a mature product. Oh, please wait for the moment. Mature product means obviously people, we know the behavior of the people and people familiar about this product. We can somehow, at least we know people about the people, what are their demands for there. We can at least some past history is available so that we can apply the mathematical tool. Then this year demand pattern is expected to repeat the next year. So because it is a mature product, then what is the demand of this year? It will be repeated for the next year. Then to forecast next year demand, the past 52 weeks demand record were collected. So the company, they want to make the forecast for the next year. Obviously, they are using the current year demand because they have the data is available. And as we are familiar, we have 52 weeks in a year. So they are using the 52 weeks to make the forecast for the next year. Now, three forecasting methods were suggested. As we saw in the previous, we talk about three last period method as suggested by Annie Chang. Last period method means, for example, if you have the, for example, right now we were in the month of February and we are in the last week of February. So it means what will be the next demand means, next demand. Last period method means it will be the same for the current one. It means for the first week of March, the demand should be the same as in the last period method. Then we have the four period moving average method. Four period moving average method means we have the data for last four period. Then third one is the four period weighted average method. It means weighted moving average method means we have the weightage of each of the past 4 weeks. Moreover, as we are familiar, the most recent week should be have highest weightage as compared to the rest, and this will continue. What they do? Management want to determine if the stationary model can be used or not. It means in the next slide we will see some data for 52 weeks. In this data they have the demand for boxes. What the management want to decide if the it is the stationary model can be applied or something else will be required. As I just mentioned, what is stationary model? In which statistical properties, that is the mean, variance, extra, they are constant over the interval of time. What forecast? Then we need to define for what forecast will be obtained using each of these methods. It means each of these three methods, we need to, if it is a forecasting, it is a stationary model, then we, what are the output, what are the results? Let's see. Okay. Here in this slide, we have the collection of demand. Right now we have the demand or data of past 52 weeks. As we are familiar, a year consists of approximately 52 weeks. So week one, this is week one, demand. Then week two demand, week three demand. These are the demand of the boxes, demand of some product. So in the other way, in the same way, we can say we have the data for 52 weeks corresponding to the demands for the, these are the demand of the product. So, okay, then what we need to do? First, we need to check either stationary model can be applied or cannot be applied. If the stationary model can be applied, then this rest of the categories for the method can be applied. Otherwise, we need to do something else. How can we define, describe, or determine that stationary model can be applied? So in this slide, what I mentioned, that we have the data for 52 weeks with the demand of the boxes or product, etc. Let's see, construct the time series. It means here we will construct a table, we construct from the table the type, the plot the time series. Plot time series means for these are the 52 weeks data they are available. Week 1, week 2, week 3, week 4, week 5 until week 52. This is week 52. Okay. Then on the y-axis, we have the corresponding demand. Demand for 0, 100. So when you plot this graph from the previous table, it is found that more or less we are corresponding to the straight line. Obviously, there are some error over there. These are the some error. But their corresponding straight line. One more thing about when these graph does not show the trend, that is increasing trend or decreasing trend. No, it is not show the decreasing or increasing trend. More or less they are straight line. So in other words, if I can show you, if it, for example, if there is a trend over there, then we cannot use the stationary model. So now come back to the description. Construct the time series plot from the table. From the table, we plot this graph. Neither stationary nor cylindrical effect are observed. For the stationary, for the season or the cylinder effect, they are not, because for the season or the cylindrical cyclical effects, they are either they are increasing or decreasing as mentioned here. But we don't find the season, we don't find the cycle. Then if we can say this is a stationary model, then we can apply the methods that will be defined in the stationary model. That will be defined in the stationary model. So it means we can apply the stationary model. Now, what we are required, suppose we, what is the forecast for the week 53? Recall that as we saw, we need to make the forecast for the next week. How many data we are available? We are available data for the 52 weeks. For the next week, 53 weeks. We know make the forecasting. The data is available only 52. So it means what is the demand for the week 52 for 84 boxes. So in other words, we can say last period method in which the demand for the week 53, this is the, then for the week 53, it should be equal to the week 52, that is 484 boxes. Why? Because we are using the last period method. As I just mentioned, if you are using last period method for the first week of March, it will be the same as the last week of February. Then we need to find out the four period method. What is the four period method? Last, to make the forecast for week 53, okay, then using the technique for the four period, what we required, last four entries should be added. Come back to the statement. What are the last four? It means to make the forecast, what are the last four? These are the last four entries. We should be make the average. 484 plus 482 plus 393 plus 245. These are the demand for 52, 51, 50, and 49. make a summation, divide by 4, 4 at 4, 4 at, please see these values, please see these values. So 4 at 4, 4 at 4, 4 at 2, 4 at 393, 4 to 45, 52, week 52, week 51, week 50, week 49. These are the last 4 entries were there. If you find the average, divide by 4, then this is our answer, 401 boxes. Now, if you want to make the forecast with the 4 period weighted moving average method, it means some weightage should be given to us. And moreover, one more thing important thing is highest weightage should be given to the most recent one. For example, if you want to make the forecast for the first week of March, highest weightage should be given to the last week of February. So in here, what we find the weightage given as 0.4, 0.3, 0.2 and 0.1. These are the weightage given to us. So it means, moreover, as we saw, the highest weightage should be given to the most recent one, most close to the week 52, then this highest weightage. So what we just weightage multiplied by the corresponding demand, 484, as we see here. I will change the color. Then 484, then here weightage for 0.3, 482, 482, then 393, 393, 244. These are the demand we have get from the previous table. So when we solve it, it is equal to 441.3 boxes. So these are the, so what we apply in this session model, we applied the last period method, full period method, and the 4 period weighted moving average method. Inshallah, this will continue. I will solve this problem. This problem will be solved with the next slides we will come to. Now, forecast for the week 54 and 55. Suppose we were given, we need to find out forecast for the week 54 and 55. As we are familiar, we have only data for 52 weeks. Whereas in the previous slide, we find the forecast for week 53. Then here we need to find the forecast for 54 and 55 week. Then what we will do, then as we are familiar, let me show you. Since the time series is stationary, because it is stationary, the forecast for the week 54 and week 55 the same as the forecast for week 53. As we saw, let me show you in the previous slide where it is mentioned. Yes. Here it is found the forecast for the period. T plus 1. Is the forecast of all of the, for example, it means, in other words, we can say forecast for week 53 somehow calculated. It will be which is equal to for something we, as we saw in the previous. It will be same for all of the remaining 53 week, 54 week, 55 week, 56 week, and it will be revised only when the new data is available, as we saw in the previous slide. Yes, it will be remain the same as the V43. These forecasts will be revised pending observation of the actual demand in the week. So this forecast will be continue, will be the same unless and until we have some new data, or other thing is if the factor that will be affecting for V43 has been changing, so then the rest of the forecast will be changing. Otherwise this will be the same, because we cannot do anything. But moreover, for the some other model, some initial starting point will be required, and this provide the starting points. Now let's talk about the disadvantage of the moving average method. Previously we saw the moving average method, in which we talk about the last period method. Then we talk about then we talk about the moving average method. Then we talk about the weighted moving average method. Previous method, they have some disadvantages were there. What are these? What are these disadvantages? We have the data for 1 year. That is, we have data for 52 weeks. Whereas in the previous method, we only use with the period, means either 4 period, 3 period, etc. Rest of the data that are available, we did not use. For example, for although we have the year, we have the data for 1 year. That is, we have 52 weeks. But how many weeks for we use for the moving average, moving average? Just use the period. That is 4. It means the rest of the data we did not use. This is one of the disadvantage. Let's see how compensate. Weighted moving average method can put greater weight on the most recent observation. As I mentioned, most recent observation should have the highest weightage because they are more close to the condition. It uses only the n period data. N means 1 week, 2 week, 3 week, 4 week, and only n week, only n period method. But and ignore the history of the time series prior to that time. For example, here in the previous example, we only use for the last 4 periods, whereas the remaining 48 weeks we did not use. So, and the prior to that time, that is let me show you. Here in the previous slide, we just use this one. These data will be used. What about the rest of this data? They are also available, but we did not use this data. In our example, prior to that data, we did not use. Then expert think that there must be some mechanism. Then how can we use this data? Let's see. Just ignore the history of the data period with that. Increasing N, that is, make forecast less sensitive to change. For example, what are the possibility that here? Here we use n equal to 4, that is last 4 method will be used. On the one of the technique is, if we increase instead of 4, we use, for example, 5, 6, 7, 8. For example, this data we can use this one, then more number of n will be used. One of the so might be the solution, but it has again disadvantage. Increasing n make forecast less sensitive to change. So, but increasing n will have the forecast less sensitive because might be possible 4 months ago, 3 months ago, what has been happened, they might not be apply for the most recent one. Does not forecast trend well. So, this type of technique, increasing n, will not, we can say something good for, or we cannot find the good forecast. It requires much historical data. Then what should we do? We can make use exponential smoothing technique. That will be discussed in the next slide. Let's see what are the technique and how it will compensate the what is drawback in the previous. For example, in the it will, let's see what it will, we will compensate. First we are dealing about the, we are using the exponential smoothing technique. What are the basic theory? What does it, let's see, then we will proceed as. This technique is used to forecast stationary time series. One of the condition, this technique will be used for stationary time series. It means when we draw the graph from x axis in the time and y axis along with the demand or etc. It must be constant. For example, with the graph is look like this. It is not something trend or this. In case you want to know, then or if that is something a trend is, if we found some trend, for example, in the when we draw the graph, then its exponential model cannot be proceed. For example, we found the trend just like this. No, we cannot use. Now, all the previous value of the historical data affect the forecast. The basic concept for the forecasting is all of the data will be used. In this way, we can say for the 52 weeks, all will be included to make the forecast. For each period, then what is the steps that will be required? That will be more clear. For example, this step will be more clear. First, I will explain this. Then I will come back to the edge. First, I will explain this. What we required in the exponential technique is, we will define FT plus one. What is the? It consists of the combination of two parts, part number one and part number two. What is this? What we required here, the forecast FG is the forecast for the time t plus one. FT plus one represents it is a forecast for the next, that is t plus one. For example, we want to make the forecast for week 53. Then it means t we have data for t 52, t plus 150, then it will be equal to LT, okay. Then the first part is multiplied by the alpha YT. Second part is multiplied by the alpha, 1 minus alpha, multiplied by F of T. Notice that this is F of T. And this is the forecast for T plus 1. Next forecast, it is the, what will is the forecast for the current one, current and for the next week. It consists of two parts. Notice it consists of two parts. Part YT. So what is the YT? Is the value of the forecast. What is the observed value for the forecast T plus for the T? And alpha is a smoothing factor. Some factor is given to us. So it means this. Noted this point for this forecast. It consists of the two parts. That is alpha, which is a smoothing factor multiply observed or estimated current value, then plus 1 minus alpha, second part, multiply the current forecast F of T. Come back to the previous slide. For each of the period created, first we will create a smooth value. For each of the period, first we will create a smooth value represented by L of T. Recall in the previous slide we saw the value L of T. I will show you again. First we will create a smooth value of the time series. That represents the all of the information known by the time T. So it means, for example, we started with week 1, then we end for week 52. What we will create? We will create the LT, that the smooth value for week 1, then for week 2, for week 3, week 4, week 5, continue until week 52. What important thing is, for each of the week, or as we are proceeding towards all of the previous value will be included. For example, for the week 2, it also consists of the week 1. Week 3, make the smooth value, it consists of week 2, week 1. In the same way, if you are reaching toward the week 52, it consists of all of the value on all of the previous, starting from week 1 until week 51. The smooth value LT is the weighted average. So this L is the weighted average of, as I told you, two parts were there. Part number 1 and part number 2. As I just shown the equation, I will show you again. This way LT is the average of two parts. Part 1 and part 2. What is the part? The current actual value represents the Y of T multiplied by the current period actual value, that is Y of T, with the weight of alpha multiplied by the alpha, as I show you. The second one is the forecast value for the current period. Forecast value for the current period is equal to F of T multiplied by 1 minus alpha, this part. As I just moved, then the smooth value LT become the forecast for the period of the T plus 1. This is the smooth value. Now it is the forecast for T plus 1. Now let's show you. This will be more clear when we show the numerical also. So for the exponential smoothing technique, first we will, what is equal to forecast for that forecast for the time t plus 1, it is equal to its value, this is the smooth value for time t. Then it consists of the two parts, part 1 and part 2. Part 1 is alpha, which is a smooth factor, smoothing factor. Then 1 minus alpha, we can easily compute it. If alpha were given to us or weight some given to us, then it consists of y of t is the current forecast at time t. Then here plus second part is consists of the F of T, forecast for time T. Now the point is here in this equation. Suppose alpha is someone give me alpha. Okay. Moreover, we have the data is available. Y of t are available, but we do not know the initial forecast. That is forecast for t. We do not know. Then what should we do? In this equation, alpha is given to you, or give we can find out. We can then estimate it. We have the data for 52 weeks. Y of t we are given. But we don't know how do we compute the initial condition f of t. Initial forecast is needed to start the process. For example, if starting with t equals to 1, for example, t equals to 1, then 2, then t equals to 3. This process until we reach to week 52. Okay, then for the so even for obviously we have alpha is given to us. Then for time then the other y of t, y of 1 plus y of 1, y of 2, y of 3, we were given in the previous table, but we don't know. This f of t, this is somehow as you can see, this is y of 1, y of 2, y of 3, y of 4, y of 5. This process will continue, y of 52. But forecast we were not given, then we somehow need to calculate, compute the forecast. We need so that we can start the process. Once we find the forecast, once we find t f of 1, then obviously this f of 1, for example, f 1, it will compute it to f t t plus 1, 1 plus 1 is equal to 2, then f 2. It means we for the f of 2, we were already computed. But at least how do we start f of 1 will be required. Now come back to the slide now. What we use, we have a different approaches to find out how do we compute the initial forecast so that we can compute f of 2. Because here in the previous we have a t f t plus 1. F t plus 1 we need to compute. Here we have two part, part 1 plus part 2, in which we required f of 1. We required f of 1. So if somehow compute the f of 1, then it will be I can compute f of 2, etc. Then one of the approaches, we have several approaches over there, that for f of 2, that is l of 1. Require the previous noted this equation, important one. Suppose this is l1, l2, l3 is multi factor. Then alpha we are given, y1, y2, y3 we were given to us. Then alpha we are given to us. But for but if we don't know the f1, we don't know f1. So if somehow we were given this f of t, then this process will start it. Now how, if for example, if I know f1, then I can easily compute f of 2, this one f of 2. So one of the approaches, suppose we can assume that okay, f of 2 is equal to l y of 1. One of the assumption is, make the first f of 2 is equal to y of 1. That is, forecast for f2 is equal to the current value for the current value represented by current value or observed value or actual value. One of the technique, then because we find the f of 2, then apply the equation, we can f of 3, f of 4, f of 5, f of 6, etc. This one. Another approach is, for example, because we required f of 1, I am unable to find f of 1, then what if they find the average of all of the previous value? Find the average of all of the previous value, that is, make the average of 52 weeks. This can be used. Or if third approach can be, for example, then we can start the initial initialization. Then another is we can make the initial average of initial n values. As for example, we can to find the f of 1, then we can make the average of last n values, that is y1 y2 y3. We can use n equal to 3, n equal to 4, n equal to 5, etc. The point is here, something required for the initialization. So here is the approach number two, is average the n initial n values of the time series. Then once you find it, then we can start our process. For example, here in the for example, f of f n plus 1, it is the average of n values. Average of n values, n can be 1 period, 2 period, 3 period, 4 period, based on our requirement of what are the in the exam, what the question, what were we given, we can easily make the average. We can here, but the bar shows the average. Make that biggest process. Then using the average as the forecast for n plus 1, once you identify this is the forecast, this is the using the average y represented by y bar dash, and it can be represent the forecast. Can be the forecast. This is the average, represent the average, and this is the forecast. Begin using the exponential, then we can start our process onwards. For example, in the previous slide, please show, have a look what is the what this shows. For example, if somehow if we found the for here for t plus whatever the value do we have, increase the t plus 1. Then f of n plus 2, as if for example, as we saw here, we saw t equal to n plus 1. So then alpha y n plus 1 minus alpha f of n plus 1. Recall that in the previous, what we have done, the t equals to n plus 1. As it is mentioned here, t equals to episode. Then we can find out alpha yn plus 1 minus alpha and replace the value here. We have replaced this value with this one, average. So this will be more clear when I solve you one of the numerical. Then it will be much more clear. What does it mean? But what you emphasize for this type of the calculation is something that will be required for initializing the process for the exponential smoothing factor, and we require the second part of the factor, that is f1. Somehow we need to compute and calculate it. Now what about the future forecast for the, as we saw right now, it means we can calculate for the forecast using a smooth exponential technique with the v53. Now what about the week 54 and week 55, 54 and 55, or so on, as we saw in the previous. Okay, what can we, since the techniques deal with a stationary time series, the forecast for the future does not change. That is for the 54, week 54, 55, 56, that will be remain the same until unless we have some additional data. Now assuming the n is the number of period for which data are available, so let's see, for example, n represents the number of period for which the data is available. In our case, how many period we are available? For example, we were available 52 weeks. Then n plus 1 is for week 53 that is available. Then for n plus 1, that is for week 53, alpha yn, then alpha is the smoothing factor, y1 is the what is the value for the week 52 plus 1 minus alpha f of n. Then 1 minus alpha given to us, f of n is forecast for the period n. One more thing about, for all of the value n plus k, that is 54, 55, 56, 57, it will be the same, whatever what we get here. So here, for example, V54, 55, 56, 57, this possibility, it will be equal to forecast for N plus 1, that is V53. Now, these concepts, first we will solve this one, then we will apply the concept. As suppose alpha is given to us as the, alpha is given to us 0.1. And smoothing is forecast is suggested with alpha is equal to 0.1. So moreover, somehow we were given the initial forecast. As we saw in the previous slide, we were given some initial, different approaches can be used. For example, in the exam, I will show you, I will tell you which approach will be used. Here, what they mentioned that the initial forecast is created at time T2. Here, the condition is create the initial forecast at time T2 by F of 2 is equal to Y of 1, which is equal to 415. I will show you in the next slide how it will be implemented. The recursive formula used for the V53 and onwards. So, for example, because we were given at time t equal to 2, it means for the t1, we will not do anything because here the condition is we started the initial forecasting with the at time t2. For time t1, we can write not applicable. For time t2, which we can apply, but the forecast is given as Y of 1, whatever the observed value, and this so on. So let me show you. Yes, the recursive formula is used for the week for the T3, T4, T5, T3, etc. This process will continue until until we find the week 53. For week 54, 55, 56, it will be the same. So, for example, here because alpha is equal to 0.1, as we saw, because F of 3. Why we have start F of 3? Because it is given at initial forecast will be from time period 2. Okay, is equal what is the formula? Alpha 1 minus alpha of y2, alpha of y2, then 1 minus alpha, which is 0.9, is F of 2. What is F of 2? We were given a 415. 415, this is the value. Then this is the 1 minus alpha, this is alpha. Then what is the y2? Let me show you what is y2. Okay, let me show you where is the Y2. Okay, in the next slide, for example, here this is Y1, Y2, Y3, Y4, Y5, Y6, Y7, Y7. This process will continue at it cannot be fit in a single slide. Then week 51, week 52. Where these other data will be given as y something y of t, where t is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. These, because in the previous slide it was given as for the initial forecast will be started at t equal to 2, and moreover, the what is the initial f? This is f of t. So, initial forecast, so it is mentioned the initial forecast is equal to 415. As it is mentioned here, then we can compute for there. Then we can compute applying the formula for the forecast for the F of 3. This is F of 3, F of 4. Then this process will continue. Come back to the previous slide. Here it is mentioned that it is the data for this is the data for alpha 1 minus alpha. This is the y of 2, as I show you. Then this is, as it is mentioned, y of 1, 415. Solving for this one is equal to 397.1. Moreover, now we need to calculate f of 4. How do we compute f of 4? That alpha y of 3 multiplied by 1 minus alpha f of 3. We already computed f of 3 here, for example, then they will be used here. Whereas, what about f of 3? What is y of 3? Y of 3 we were given as, for example, here y of 3 is equal to 348. Y of 3, 348. Then we find the this is f of 4. Then we can find f of 5, f of 6, f of 7, f of 10. This process will continue until we reach to the week 53. Which is equal to n plus 1, n plus 1, 52 plus 1, 53. So, in other words, we can say for the first for week 53 is equal to alpha of current value which are given in the table for 52, 1 minus alpha forecast for 52. Then we were given alpha is equal to 0.1, and this is the forecast for 52 is equal to 484 plus. Let me show you. It is a forecast for 52 is 484. Okay, what is the forecast? 371. वो प्रीवियस फोरकास्ट 371, देन 484, देन वी इज इक्वल टू व्हाट इज 0.9, बट देन हियर फॉर द प्रीवियस फोरकास्ट इज इक्वल टू 379, देन व्हाट हियर 382. For the V52 is equal to 382.32. So it means somewhere here, 382, we are computing the here for the we are in the forecast for V53, and we were given as forecast for V52 is equal to 382 point. Here this is the YT, Y52. Applying the formula here, then we computed 392 point. What about the forecast for V54, 55, 56, 57? It will be the same unless and until V52, unless we have some new data is available. So all of this process, they are shown with this Excel sheet. Here, what is represent the time T? This is represent the Y observed value or the available value for time T. This is the forecast for time T. The condition is given as initial, the period will be started 2, whereas it is not applicable for the first one. These are the data they were given to us. These are the data they were given to us. We need to compute this for the first one. For first forecast, we were given that it is equal to this one. And it is equal to this one. Rest, what about the rest? That is forecast for 3, 4, 5. We need to compute it. One more thing about, because we 52 data for 52 weeks we were given to us, then we can compute 53 forecast, which is equal to 392.48. The rest of the forecast, they are the same, because unless and until we have some new data. Now if we plot the graph from the for the these are the weeks they are the weeks if we plot the graph, and moreover using the exponential smoothing techniques, this one, and moreover this in the Y we have the our demand or Y observed value, then it is equal to then let me show you then it is found that these are the sum of our, for example this blue one dot, what they represent, they represent our observed value or current value or available value, whereas this one it shows the using the these are the value with the pink one, what we get using the exponential applying technique. Yeah, the as you can see, notice the amount of smoothing included in the smoothing series. As you can see, actual value is much more variation. Using the exponential technique, our values, they are very smooth. We are very smooth. So this is one of the advantage, use the exponential technique. One more thing about these, noted that these require practice. Examination point of view for the numerical, if you make the if means obviously if the first step is wrong, for example if you initial forecast F1 is wrong, obviously all of the remaining values will be wrong. So all of this type of problem, they required, if you did not start correctly, all of the remaining steps will be wrong. Then how can you claim that doctor, because I follow the correct step, means if you did not make the initial forecasting wrong, rest of the forecast will be wrong. Otherwise the rest of the formula, they are very easy. Now let's talk about the performance measure. What are the performance measure? Generally to evaluate each of the forecasting method, for example right now we talk about the different type of forecasting methods over there. Last weight method, moving average method, weighted moving average method. Then we talk about the exponential method. Now we need to know about the how can we say that the which of the method can be good or can be bad. Obviously different scenarios, for different scenarios different method will be effective or helpful. How can we define, then if forecast mean predict for the future, if you will make the difference for the forecast, that is what is the difference between that them, the actual value and the forecast, then we can define yes it's a good performance or bad performance. Suppose for example, suppose I can tell okay to today the highest temperature for tomorrow, the highest temperature will be 20 degrees centigrade. Whereas, for example, I apply different method. One of the method they give is 19 degrees. Second method is 18 degrees centigrade. Fourth method is 11 degrees centigrade. What is the best method? The best method for that type of scenario, which give the minimum error. Minimum error. So, inshallah, that we will discuss later on. Inshallah, so we will discuss later on. This I will start again. Moreover, inshallah, on Tuesday, we will have the quiz number two during the lecture timing. That is from 9 o'clock. If you want to leave the session, so then thank you very much. Moreover, for example, I have already sent the rescheduled date to the examination committee. I did not receive any news yet. Inshallah, once I receive, I will update you. Thank you very much.